A couple of weeks ago, I finally committed to a long-term photo storage solution where I can dump and organize every single photo I own. I started by clearing out about 2,000 photos from my iPhone. I was at camera roll zero for the first time since I bought the phone. On iPhone, iCloud Sync ensures you won't lose your photos if you drop your phone in the ocean, which, yes, I've done. However, if you delete a photo from your phone, it deletes it from everywhere, providing zero opportunity to clear up space. Over the last 6 months, in an attempt to gain control over my 15-year history of photo hoarding, I've researched potential solutions and talked to lots of friends and family members about what their photo management situations look like. My final solution? Google Photos. Hear me out. There are other fancy options like Adobe Lightroom or Mylio, but I wanted a solution that would sync seamlessly with iPhone, allow me to access and manage my photos from anywhere, and a solution that I could trust would be around in 5 to 10 years' time. Plus, I use a lot of Google services anyway, so I wouldn't have to create any new accounts. I subscribe to Google's AI Premium plan for $20 a month to use Gemini, and that comes with 2 terabytes of free storage for Photos, Drive, and Gmail. Plenty of space for my needs, but for $25 a month, you can get an additional 5 terabytes of space, which is an absolute ton of space. If you don't want to pay for a solution, that's fair, but I'm using Google Photos to store pictures from my entire life, including photos and videos of my kids growing up. I'm willing to pay a small price for a centralized location where I can store and manage every single one of them in their full quality. The challenge, however, is breaking free from Apple's photo ecosystem and moving everything over to a new location. Don't worry though, remember how I said I achieved camera roll zero? Here is exactly how I did it. Mind the blurs, however, because this is actual footage from me moving everything over. The first thing that I did was make sure that my phone was finished syncing with iCloud Sync. This makes the transition to Google Photos a bit easier. Then I went to privacy.apple.com, logged in with my iCloud account, and clicked on the link that says request to transfer a copy of your data. It then let me know how many photos and videos I had to transfer. As you can see, I had over 2,000 photos and over 170 videos, adding up to over 45 gigabytes of space. With over 2 terabytes of space waiting for me in Google Photos, this would just be a drop in the bucket. So I clicked the dropdown to choose my transfer destination and then chose Google Photos. I then clicked the checkboxes to include both my photos and videos. After clicking continue, Apple reminds you to make sure your Google account has enough space, so just click continue again. Then you need to log in or select the Google account that you'd like to transfer the photos to. You'll need to give Apple access to some of your Google account data and then review one last confirmation regarding the transfer that you're about to start. Warning! This transfer took about 2 days to complete, so it's a good idea to do it at a time when you're not expecting to be taking a lot of photos in the next few days. But don't worry though, if you do take some new photos, I'll show you how to handle that as well. So when you're ready, click Confirm Transfers. You'll receive an immediate confirmation of the transfer initiation, and you can click to view the status of your transfer. Then, unfortunately, yeah, you just have to wait. I know it's hard nowadays, but I'm really glad I did it because I now have a central location to store and manage all of my photos from any device. 2 days later, my transfer had completed. I opened up iCloud Photos and Google Photos side by side to make sure that everything had synced. It's a good idea to look at the first and last photos in iCloud and the first and last photos in Google Photos to confirm that they match up. If you took some new photos during the transfer, we'll talk about handling that shortly. Next, I downloaded the Google Photos app to my iPhone, opened it up, and clicked the button to give it full access to my phone in my iPhone settings. Then, in Google Photos, I tapped the option to back up my photos. This makes sure that any new photos that were taken since the transfer was initiated will be backed up as well. It does take some time because it's going to check all of the photos and videos on your phone to make sure they're all backed up. You can actually use this option instead of initiating the transfer via iCloud, but the chances that something goes wrong or that your phone gets hung up are much greater. I actually got a bit impatient at this point, so I went into Google Photos and I just made sure that all of my new recent photos were in there, and they were. So now it was time to disable iCloud Sync. I went into my phone settings, tapped on my name at the top to access my Apple account settings, tapped on iCloud, tapped on Photos, and then unchecked the Sync This iPhone setting. On the warning, I tapped Remove from iPhone to verify that I'd like to remove my iCloud Photos. Next, I tapped on the Manage Storage button. Then I did it. With my fingers shaking, I tapped Turn Off and Delete from iCloud. A warning appeared, letting me know that without another backup, many of my photos and videos would be permanently deleted after 30 days. No worries, Google Photos has me covered. I tapped Continue anyway. One last warning. Here we go, delete. Immediately, my iCloud storage went from almost 50 gigabytes to zero. I checked the Photos app on my phone, and although about 2/3 of my photos and videos were gone, quite a few recent photos and some iCloud albums were still left. I didn't wait around to see if they would disappear. I manually went into my recent photos, selected all of them, and deleted them. For my shared iCloud albums, I used a workaround to make sure that they were completely backed up. On my phone, I tapped and held on each album and clicked the Share Photos option. Then I clicked the option to save the images. With the images now locally saved on my phone, I tapped and held on each album and selected Delete Album. I then checked Google Photos, and sure enough, it was already backing up all of these photos. I went back to my iPhone Photos app and boom, I was at camera roll zero for the first time since buying the phone. I checked and I now had over 450 gigabytes of free space on my iPhone. To access all of my photos, just open the Google Photos app. If you want access to some of your photos offline, you can just download those individual photos to your phone's camera roll. I usually use the favorite feature in Google Photos and then download those photos to my phone to have offline. If you take a new picture, it will be immediately synced with Google Photos. You can then delete it from your phone and it will be saved to Google Photos. Obviously, you don't need to do this after taking every single photo, but as soon as your phone starts to get low on space, just go into your camera roll and wipe it clean. Probably good to check Google Photos first to make sure that things are backed up. Cleaning out space on your phone is just the beginning though. One of the main reasons I used Google Photos was because I could access it from any device. So now you can go to your computer and open up all of those old photo libraries you have saved from high school or that folder that's stuffed with a bunch of random photos, and you can drag them right into Google Photos and then delete them from your computer. This solution has finally given me the freedom to shoot 4K video whenever I want, to endlessly take pictures on the weekend when I'm hanging out with my family, and to never have to worry about what happens if I lose my device or am I almost out of space. No, it's all there in Google Photos to manage whenever I want. With your phone all cleaned up, it's time to organize that mess of files that you have on your Mac computer. Check out this video next, and I'll make it easy for you by showing you the power of smart folders. Good luck clearing out all of that digital clutter, everyone. That's all I've got for today. I'm Anson Alexander, and I'll see you in the next one.